Na, mit ein paar mehr davon hätten wir bestimmt das gesamte Geschwader erledigt.
Ich schätze, die meisten machen wohl noch an der Ostfront die Russenpanzer platt.
Motor. Ist da jemand?
Changes then. Check 1, 2. That's still working. Let's go back to here. Yeah. There we go. Thank you. Check 1-2. Yeah, it's more like it. Now, where is that audio coming in so hot? Still too high. Check 1-2. Check 1-2. That's looking good. Now, this source has to come down as well. Check 1-2. Check 1-2. Check 3-4. There we go. Let's try this again, this time with the microphone, and we'll see just how. I'm not sure how you control the volume on that. Let's see. Okay, so sharpening's coming up, blah 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 blah. So far so good. Let's see if I can get some good maneuvering in this thing. I can't play with the shit, but you know. Okay, so that's good. We will get this shit all figured out. After a good start. We're still running about 30% of the CPU usage, which is good. I think I'm running as administrator, so that should bring it to the top. It's a pretty fast-loading game, actually. Considering some of them are so slow. Now, Ground Branch is very slow. That game takes forever to load up. Check 1-2. Okay, we got audio on both. Laptop, which is feeding. Actually, I don't know if it is feeding it, is it? Yes, it is. So before I do that, I'm just going to do a quick switch here. And let's see if it brings up the other shot. should. There we go. So the quality is fantastic. Very impressed by that. Let's see, on the laptop, yeah, it's 27% as well. So I'm gonna sneak out of here before I get busted. Okay, where am I at here? I'm at 28 minutes. Won't carry this on too long. This is a really good test. Okay, get my pistol out. I can take the rifle, that's fine. Although it's pretty fucking loud, isn't it? There we go.
Yeah, how did it go?
Yeah, we didn't say anything.
Oh, sorry, I had my headphones on.
Yeah, good. Oh, gee, he ran like a fucking... It's in flops on the Maxi. Give him water, Shay.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's what I learned today. I'm just going to turn my mic off. You can see my mic. I figured out how to get my mic going from this computer to this one, which is actually feeding. That's the encoder.
Okay,
so I won't have this computer when we go to the thing. This is actually my cameras. Everything's going to go into here. And the way it goes in, it's not by plugging into it. It's through that switcher, you see?
Okay, yes.
So what I did is when you put that cable in there, now this computer can become an NDI source. That's what you're seeing there. There's no other cable except the fact that I'm hooked up to that router.
Okay.
So
when we go, though, what do you have as your NDI source? Because obviously you don't have...
Well, there'll be the cameras. So I'm going to have these two cameras
plus
the regular camera. The regular camera does not have an Ethernet out on it.
Okay.
So we have to use that little thing. So that's for the camera to get into the computer.
Okay.
So that has to be plugged into the computer.
Mm-hmm.
These two things have to be plugged into there. Mm-hmm. All the computers get plugged into there. Yeah. Well, and it's look at the percentage. The most it's gotten to is 34% of the CPU usage.
Yeah.
Compared to, and this is at 1080 60. We were doing 1080 30 at low data rates. This is at quite a high data rate. In fact, I'm at what am I at here? I'm at about 10,000. Actually, I'm at 8,000 kilobytes per second.
And then that little bar helps as well. Hey, switch to different things.
That little thing, yep. It will eventually be hooked up. I'm not sure which one I'm going to hook it up to. This is all new to me. This is a new way to do this, right?
Yeah.
It's all cool. Then to get the signal to the display system that they have there, I have to have an HDMI out. So that's the one trick I got to figure out is which one, how am I going to get a HDMI out? So what I'm thinking is I'm going to use that little computer and just basically do a full screen thing. So basically I'll be following the program on here as an NDI source. So I'll run another cable into that, another Ethernet cable. So that'll become an NDI source that we'll be putting the output to. So, and then that, we can just connect the HDMI right to the display unit they have in the AV room, and that's going to be what's displaying all over. So without running fucking HDMI cables and everything else, just Ethernet cables, which are cheap, and they're light, and they're easy to string, right? So it's fantastic. I'm really, really quite thrilled. Yeah. That's fantastic. Thank you.
Yep.